Hello,
I'm Diana, and I'm here to get you up and running with Office Timeline Free Edition. In this quick start guide, we're going to touch on quite a few key topics, as well as a workflow demo. So remember, we've included chapter markers to help you navigate the video. First up, a quick primer on the Office Timeline interface and its most important features. The main place to interact with Office Timeline is this ribbon up here. Select it and you'll see all the main functionalities of the add-in. The ones you'll probably spend the most time with are the data view, the timeline view, and the style pane. Let's start with the data view. This is where you edit, well, data. Here you can create and edit tasks, milestones, swim lanes, and sub-swim lanes directly within Office Timeline. You can also copy data over from Excel, as we'll see during the demo. Next up, the timeline view. This is where you start working on one of the visual aspects of your timeline, the way everything is positioned on the slide. Here you can move items around easily by dragging and dropping. You can even drag the timescale to reposition the entire timeline. If you want to hide an item from your timeline, select it and press delete on your keyboard. To bring it back, go to the data view, find the item and click this eye symbol. When you're done making changes, remember to click save. Now we get to the style pane, where we take care of the second visual aspect of your timeline, the way each task, milestone, swim lane, and sub-swim lane looks. In the style pane, you can edit shapes, colors, fonts, the visibility of different elements, and so much more. It adapts to the type of item you have selected, revealing all the customization options specific to that item type. We'll delve into more details on that during the workflow demo later in this video. Another feature you'll find useful is the themes functionality. Themes are comprehensive visual styles that you can easily apply to any timeline, so you can maintain consistency and standardize your visuals. Now that we've covered the basics, let's go through a workflow demo to see how easy it is to create a beautiful timeline visual with Office Timeline. This is what we're going to be making. Let's start by opening the Office Timeline ribbon and clicking on New. For this guide, we'll use a very popular feature, copy and paste from Excel. Double-click on Timeline from scratch and delete the default task. Before we hit copy on our Excel data, we need to make sure that it's formatted in a way that Office Timeline can make sense of it. It's pretty simple, actually. All you have to do is to make sure that your Excel sheet has columns for titles, start dates, and end dates. Items with both dates filled in will become tasks, while those with only one date filled in will become milestones. There are also optional columns you can add, such as swim lanes, sub-swim lanes, notes, and percentage complete. Also, remember that for the free version of Office Timeline, you are limited to a maximum of 10 items per timeline. Once your data is properly formatted, select everything and click Copy. Then switch over to Office Timeline and click on the Paste button up here. And there you go, your Excel data has turned into a timeline. Now let's make it look better. Right now we're in the data view, which is used for importing and editing the data. So let's switch over to the timeline view to start working on the visuals. First, let's resize the swimline headers to fit the text properly. Then, let's use the drag-and-drop feature to group these tasks together, and then move the entire group by holding the Ctrl key and dragging. Now center everything by moving the timescale. There, your timeline already looks better. But we can do even more. We can customize each item using the style pane. So click on Create to exit the timeline view, and make sure the style pane is enabled. Each type of item has different customization options, so let's start with our tasks and milestones, since their styling options are very similar. Select a task title and make the text a bit larger, then change its position and color. Use the Apply to All button and uncheck this swim lane only to make all the other task titles on the slide look the same. Now let's do something similar for the dates. Change the size, position, and color. Then use Apply to All. However, we don't want to see dates on these tasks, so we'll just select them with Shift-click and disable their dates. And finally, let's change the shapes and sizes of our tasks, then turn off the percentage complete indicator. Remember to use Apply to All so you save time. Now let's make some tasks look a bit different. Select this one and change the shape. Let's speed through adjusting the colors, since we've done it a few times already and the process is the same. Next, let's do something similar for our milestones. First, let's change the timescale milestones. Select them and change their shapes and font sizes. Now mix it up a bit by changing each of their colors separately. Do the same for the timeline milestones. Change their shapes and font sizes. Then their colors. You can do this kind of styling on swim lanes as well. First, let's hide the grid lines and set their colors to something nicer. Then increase the size of our swim lane titles and make them bold. Do the same for our sub-swim lanes. Hide the grid lines, change the font, and then the colors. You can also customize the timescale, but the process is a little bit different this time. You can edit the fonts and colors the same way you've done so far, but for some of the more advanced settings, you need to open the timescale settings menu. Here you can enable and set up multiple timescale tiers. Let's change their colors to the ones we've already used throughout our visual. And set their measurement units to years, quarters, and months. When you're done, click Save. There are also some extra elements you can play around with, but for this particular example, let's just keep them disabled. The last thing you can do in the Style Pane is customize your dependencies and critical path, but we first have to set them up. So let's do exactly that, starting with dependencies. In the timeline view, let's rearrange these tasks to make room for our dependency links. Once that is done, look in the upper right part of the window and click on the Dependencies rollout, then Enable Dependencies. Now, if you select a task or milestone, you'll see two dark circles. You can click on any of them and drag to another task or milestone to link them together. Once you're done creating all the connections, click on Save. Now, you can customize dependency links using the Style Pane, just like any other timeline element. Dependencies are a complex and powerful feature, so make sure to read our support article if you want a detailed look at them. Next up, the critical path feature. After you've set up your dependencies, make sure you've got a dependency link selected. Now go to the Style Pane and switch over from dependency link to critical path, then turn the toggle from hidden to visible. You should see the critical path highlighting the chain of linked dependencies going up to your latest scheduled item. And if you want to customize the way it looks, you can do so from the Style Pane. There is a lot more to the critical path feature that we can cover in this quick start guide. So remember to check out the detailed support article we've put together. And that's it. Pretty quick and straightforward, wasn't it? Now you know how to use Office Timeline to impress people with beautiful timeline visuals. If you ever need help with something, or just want to learn more, don't forget that we have a ton of very detailed help articles and videos in the Office Timeline Support Center. Thanks for watching!